In this tutorial video, we will show you how to run code from the DHS program shared code library on GitHub in the statistical software Stata. You must have Stata software in order to be able to run the code. Additionally, this video assumes that users have a basic understanding of Stata software. Before proceeding, please watch our companion video on how to prepare to run the code, as this video assumes you have already completed those important steps. Remember that we are using the IR and MR files from the model datasets, and we will be running the code from Chapter 3, Respondents' Characteristics. Go to the RC main file and run the entire do file. Once I click the execute button, the Stata program will begin to compute the indicators and produce the tables for these indicators. The tables produced provide a simple tabulation using the tabout command in Stata and follow the standard DHS tabulation plan that is used for survey final reports. Let's take a look at what was produced after running the code. We see all the Excel files that were produced in our folder. Let's open the table for the health insurance indicators for women. This file is called tables_insurance_WM.xls. When you double-click on the file, a warning message will appear. Click on Yes to continue. When we open the Excel file, we see it starts with a cross-tabulation of the indicator Health Insurance Coverage Social Security for women by background characteristics. Here we see that 0.3% of women have this type of health insurance, and we can also see the breakdown by age, residence, region, education level, and the wealth index. You can also check to see if these results match the model dataset tables. We can see that the total in our Excel file matches the total in the model dataset table 3.8.1. 0.3% of women aged 15 to 49 have health insurance through Social Security. You can also see the indicators produced in Stata. Remember, this do file uses the IR or women's recode first, followed by the MR or men's recode. Since the MR file comes second, this file remains open in Stata, and we see the Chapter 3 indicators produced for men from the model datasets. Chapter 3, the respondent characteristics chapter, only has one do file to produce indicators because it only contains one group of indicators. Other chapters have more do files to produce indicators, one for each group of indicators in that chapter. Let's look at Chapter 7, Family Planning. There are 6 different indicator-specific do files for the Family Planning chapter. Each do file codes a particular group of indicators. You can know which indicators are coded by each do file by opening the do file itself to see the list of indicators at the top, or by checking the indicator list that is part of the Stata repository, as explained in our video, Overview of the DHS Program's Code Share Library on GitHub. Another way to run the code is to simply copy the code for your indicator of interest to your own personal do file. For example, if you are only interested in the indicator health insurance in women, you can go back to the do file editor window, open the rc_char.do file, and find the code for that indicator. This can also be done without downloading the repository to your computer. The same indicator code is found on our code share library, so users can also copy and paste directly from GitHub into a personal do file. If you are copying and pasting specific indicator code, please read the notes in both the main file and the do file you are using to make sure you capture all the components and any important information. In some files, you need to specify the age for your population or provide other information that are located elsewhere. In addition, some indicators are country-specific and may require some manipulation of the main logic of code to produce the correct estimate. All of the information you need is provided in the notes for the do files. Please make sure to read them. The best way to get comfortable with the code share library is through hands-on practice. So dig in and explore the different files and components of the library to help you begin coding DHS indicators and analyzing DHS data today. If you do not understand why an indicator was coded in a specific way, please check the Guide to DHS Statistics, which gives detailed information about each indicator. If you have any comments or questions, email us at codeshare@dhsprogram.com or post your question on the user forum. Check out our other videos, including our other tutorials on the DHS Program CodeShare Library.